How to register for an account with SciFinder-n. SciFinder-n is a critical database for chemistry research because it provides a search infrastructure that enables you to easily find documentation for the original preparation of a compound. It also provides access to selected full-text articles from journals, technical reports, books, and more in chemistry, biology, biotechnology, and engineering. From the library homepage, click Databases, and then click Databases by Subject to view the databases grouped by discipline. Click Chemistry. SciFinder-n is listed as a key resource for chemistry. It requires a secondary registration prior to use. Open the SciFinder-n first-time user registration page. Log in with your UHCL credentials, which are the same credentials you use for Blackboard and your UHCL email. Click Next. Read and accept the license agreement. Fill out the registration form completely. All fields are required unless otherwise stated. Note that you must use your UHCL student email address to authenticate your account. You can use the separate username and password from your UHCL login or your SciFinder-n account. Be sure to make note of your security question and answer, as this will be used to recover your account if you forget your password. Once finished, click Register. You will receive an email from CAS with a link to complete your registration. The link is valid for only one use and will expire within 96 hours, so it is important to confirm your account as soon as possible. When you receive the email from CAS, it will ask you to agree to the terms of the license agreement. Complete the registration by clicking on the hyperlink provided in the email. Once your account is successfully confirmed, you can use the main SciFinder-n database link to access SciFinder-n. You may need to log in with your UHCL credentials again if you have closed the window from your previous session. Once you see the SciFinder-n database login screen, enter your new SciFinder-n credentials you created earlier. For more help, visit our library homepage and be sure to ask a librarian.